In 1956, Astron officially took the Dwingeloo Radiotelescoop into use. For a time, it was the largest movable radio telescope in the world. And although Astron currently no longer uses the telescope to acquire scientific data, the 25-meter dish has provided the Netherlands Institute for Radio Astronomy with many scientific data and insights throughout the years. Around the 50s of the previous century, pioneering radio astronomer Jan Oort really wished for a large dish to observe the 21-centimeter hydrogen line of our galaxy. With such a telescope, he would be able to observe the distribution of neutral hydrogen in our own Milky Way. He came up with an idea to make this 25-meter dish, which is covered by chicken wire and therefore also called the chicken wire telescope. In 1954, construction started with NWO, the Dutch Organization for Science, together with Astron. Once the dish was built, astronomers started to use it and they found they analyzed the movement and structure of the Milky Way. They were particularly interested in the core area of the Milky Way, where the gas made a very erratic movement. Through their observations, astronomers found a spiral arm in the inner part of a Milky Way, which was moving outward. They also found a gas cloud above our Milky Way, which moved with great velocity towards us. At first, astronomers thought that the movements that they found had an explosive origin. But later, these ideas were adjusted. The findings from this telescope shocked the scientific world. The telescope was designed to observe at a frequency of 1420 MHz, or 21 centimeter. And this is the frequency at which hydrogen has a spin-flip transition. However, the first observations with this telescope were performed at 75 centimeters, or a frequency of 400 MHz. At that frequency, the Crab Nebula was observed. Observations with the Dwingeloo Radio Telescope produced a first catalogue of discrete sources. It also produced a map of the magnetic field of our Milky Way. Let's take a look inside. At the time that the dish was built, computers were too slow to convert galactic coordinates into coordinates on Earth. Therefore, an analog computer was built, called the pilot. Using the pilot, astronomers could point the telescope at any position in the sky that they wished to study. During its lifetime, the Dwingeloo Radio Telescope was upgraded several times. In 1966, the construction of a new telescope started, called the Westerbork Synthesis Radio Telescope. Even though that this telescope was finished in 1970, and was way more sensitive than the Dwingeloo Radio Telescope, the Dwingeloo Radio Telescope remained an important instrument for science.
One of these breakthroughs is the discovery of a new galaxy behind the Milky Way in 1994 by René Kraan-Korteweg, at that time a KNAW fellow at the Kapteyn Institute of the University of Groningen.
Through thorough analysis of radio waves, astronomers can discriminate between radio waves approaching from nearby, relatively speaking, and from further away. With the radio waves of the Milky Way mapped, astronomers were able to penetrate the dense curtain of gas and dust in the Milky Way, something that an optical telescope cannot achieve. By doing so, Kraan-Korteweg found a new galaxy behind the Milky Way. She named the galaxy Dwingeloo 1. One of the two satellite systems of this galaxy is named Dwingeloo 2.
During that same year, Dab Hartmann made his sensitive all-sky survey of the 21-centimeter line radiation.
In 1998, the telescope was put in the so-called storm mode, which it didn't come out of until 2007, the year in which CAMRAS was founded, and was given management over the telescope. It remains, however, the property of Astron. The telescope, which is now a national monument, underwent a thorough restoration in 2012 and 2013 and is currently being used by CAMRAS for educational purposes and amateur radio astronomy. And that is how the Dwingeloo Radiotelescoop served and to this day continues to serve the Astronomy Society.